Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and if you don't know who I am, my name is Lisa. I am a calligraphy YouTuber that does a lot of makeup content. But today I'm doing a favorite video, a current favorites, and I'm going to talk about some shoes, a bag, some skincare, and makeup. And I hope you can't see any of the things. And these are not like typical like July favorites, this is just favorites that I have had the last couple of weeks. And I just wanted to show you, and I'm going to start with the bag and the two pair of shoes. So we can start with the bag. And I am not... Designer brands is not for me, and also like most of the designer bags are in leather. And I don't use leather because... I don't eat meat, and I think it's would be strange if I used leather. So I usually don't buy expensive bags. And this bag is from H&M, and I have had this for a couple of years, but I've never liked it that much. But then I started to use it one day just because I mostly wear black, and I wanted like a pop of color. And then I took this bag, and I have been using it so much. It is a yellow bag with a gold chain, and I just really like it. I have used this for like 3 weeks, every day that I'm gone out from the... every time I have had a bag with me. And it's nothing special with it, but I just think it looks... I like yellow, and it's a pop of color. The only thing it's... Here, I have some receipts. It's not that big, but... it fits what I need to have. So I really like this one. I bought it maybe like 4 or 5 years ago from H&M, so it's old. But I actually really like it. I like the shape of it. I like the color. I would wish that this was silver, but I guess it looks better with gold when it's yellow. But I've been loving this bag, and I am not going to stop using it. I just really love it. And then we're going to the two pair of shoes. And if you ever have heard me talk about shoes, you know that I love platform shoes, and I love like chunky shoes. I'm kind of short, and I have kind of small feet. And I just want my shoes to look big, because it feels like my feet are looking so small when I wear normal shoes. So I often wear platforms when I'm not driving, because I can't really drive in platforms. Some of my platforms I can, but if you have ever tried, it's kind of hard because you... shit, you can't feel the pedals, but... okay, shoes. But I have two shoes. I haven't... driven in any of these? I might can, I don't know. But these are two sandals. And we can start with the ones from a Buffalo. I love Buffalo. I am a 90s kid, and I didn't have any Buffalo shoes when I grew up because they were too expensive. So now I think I have 4 pairs of Buffaloes, but these are my sandals from Buffaloes, and these are vegan, of course. I just love these. This one you wrap around your ankle. Maybe I should have shown these on. I can put a picture how they look on. And I just think they are not that high, but they are like enough high. And these are 36. I don't know, is it size 4 in the US maybe? I have no idea. You have strange sizes. Or is it 5? No, it's 4. Or 5. I don't know. But I love these. And these look cool, but not too much. And these are so comfortable to walk in. I have walked a lot in these. And because they aren't that high. And they are really like soft. So they have been amazing now this summer. And I did get a really bad... what is it even called in English? It's called skavsår in Swedish. I have to write it here. And these worked wonderful then. So I have been loving these. And the next shoes are the shoes that gave me that scavsår. And these are these one. These are a little bit higher, and this is like platform. This is these are from Koi Footwear. It's hard to show black shoes when you have black clothes on. But these are also like sandals, and these are comfortable to walk in, but it was just that I got a little thing on my heel. But these are good to walk in, not as good as the Buffaloes, but yeah, I've been loving these and they look super cool. And the good thing about these and the Buffaloes, they work with dresses and they work with jeans, so yeah, I love these. I'm going to be sad when I can't use these anymore. Now I don't know where to put them. Okay, that was really long about shoes and bags, sorry. I think we're going to the skincare things. And yeah, we just hop into it. I've really been liking a toner, and it's the one from Ren. This is their Ready Steady Glow Daily AHA Tonic. I did take this when we were on vacation because I wanted a smaller bottle, and because the one that I have is like this big. So I took this, and first day I used it, it stinged a little bit, but it's only happened once, and my skin looked clearer. I don't know if it helps or not, but it felt like that, and I've really been liking this, and I have used this for a week, as you see. I haven't used that much, so this I have been really liking, and I'm using this at nighttime. And I think it looks really good. And the other skincare favorite is also from Ren. I have talked about this before. This is my absolute favorite day cream. It's Ren Evercalm Global Protecting Day Cream. And I have used up one of these, and now I bought a new one. Now I have used some of it, and I just love how this looks on my skin. My skin looks really good. It feels hydrating but not too heavy, and it gives me a little bit of, maybe not glow, but I look hydrated. So this I have been loving. I'm going to continue buying this because I just love it. And then another favorite is this sunscreen. I've talked about this when I did a pack makeup with me. I can leave it up here. I talked about this. This is a Daily Defense Face Mousse. High SPF 50. I need it for my pale face. And this is a mousse. And this works wonders as a primer. And it also, it's a really good face sunscreen. I've been growing up with sunscreen. And when I was little, the sunscreen weren't good. Like, I was the sticky kid in my face and all over my body. But this works so good. It is, yeah, it's really good. And it's vegan, so I love this. Okay, let's go into the makeup. And I have some base products that we can start with. And these are also talked about in my, you see it here, in my pack makeup with me. And it's the Glossier Perfect Skin Tint and Stretch Concealer. I've been using this so much this summer because it has been so freaking warm, and these just look amazing on the skin and you can't feel them. They don't give that much coverage, they just like even things out. And I have been loving this, especially together with this sunscreen. Amazing. So yeah, these two, amazing. Next up, a bronzer that I've been loving. It's Nabla's Ombra. I think I've used this. I think this is the only, I use this as contour. I think this is the only one that I've used since I bought it, almost. I just love this. I love Nabla's, I don't know, these series. I have blushes and a highlighter as well, and I just love this one. This is amazing for pale skin, and it isn't that pigmented, and I love that about it. And this works on a sticky base, on a powdery base. Just amazing. And I really recommend Nabla's. I don't know. I think they have, because this is skin bronzing, skin glaze. Maybe it's the skin series. I don't know, but amazing. If you are pale as me and looking for bronzer, contour, try this. And a blush that I've been loving, and I'm happy that I've been loving this because this was expensive. It's the Melt Digital Dust Duo Blusher in Buskill. First of all, I love how it looks. I maybe can show you. Do you see the bee? And it's like a beehive. This I took on the trip, and this was the only thing I used. And this also works on sticky base and on a powder base. I think though the highlighter isn't perfect for me. That bumps me out a little bit, but it works. But the blush, I just love it. It's a shimmery blush, but it's not too shimmery, and it looks so, so good and really like neutral. And this summer I mostly worn like a base. So this one, I'm so happy that I like it that much, because I was so like hesitated if I was going to buy it, because it costs like, how much can it be in dollars? 35 maybe? So I'm just so happy that I like it. I would be devastated if I didn't like it, but I've been loving this. Two eyeshadow palettes I want to talk about a little bit quick. And I haven't put up that many videos this summer. I know I'm on vacation right now, or I'm off work, and I'm trying to get in filming mood again. But I have used some makeup, not that much, not so much colorful makeup, and these I took on the trip. And I use these like every day. And it's the Sweet Talk palette from ColourPop. And this is like, if you look, see how I look now, and if you look at this palette, this is like not the same universe. But I've just been loving this, and I know why this is kind of popular on ColourPop. And the thing I really like about this, it has like, you can do a pink look if you want to, and you can do like a bit of a warmer look with it as well, and you have this deeper shade if you want to deepen it down. So this, I found my way back to it, and also the Lethal Memento palette. Maybe I have a thing for pink. I think it's because I didn't want to wear that much makeup this summer because it has been so hot. So these has been really good to use and just to have something, but not too much. So yeah, these two I've been really loving, and that feels a little bit strange for me, but I really have. So the last favorite for eyes. We have been on a little journey, but the latest week we have really come to an agreement, and it's the Nabla Vicious Mascara. I just want to say thank you, Alice, because it was because of you that I bought this one, and I really, really like it. It's one thing that I don't like about it. I don't know if I can show you. Maybe I can, maybe I can't. No.
Hello.
I don't know if you can see the brush, but it gets so much mascara on it, and I have to like scrape it off a little bit because either it's going to be a little bit clumpy, and I hate that, but I think it gives me a good volume and it separates them if it's not too much mascara on the brush. And this really holds up on me. I have always had a problem with mascara falling down on me and I look like a raccoon. I haven't had this with this one. As long as I like set my concealer properly, and it's so good. I've been really liking this. I don't know what I think about, is it Panther? I don't know, but I like it. It's really good, and I think I actually will buy it again, and I usually don't buy a mascara two times, so I might buy this again. We will see. It's kind of expensive for me to get it to Sweden though, but if I'm going to buy from Beauty Bay or from Nabla, I think I would buy one more. And the last thing is a lip thing, and this I have been using as crazy since I bought it, and I have had it for maybe 2 weeks, and or maybe 3 weeks. I've used it so much. It's the LH Cosmetics Infinity Lip Gloss in Mellow Mauve. As you know, lip gloss is not my thing, but this is not sticky and this looks good with a bare face, and it has SPF 15. And I've just been using this now on my vacation. I think I bought it right when I went on vacation. So, a little over 2 weeks. And I have almost used it every day. And it isn't sticky. And it just feels great on the lips. I've been loving this one. And for me to say that about a lip gloss, yeah. I'm actually thinking about buying it. There's 2 more colors. I think I'm going to buy 1 more because this one is great. And you know what? That was actually all of my favorites, my current favorites. I really hope you liked this video. I don't know how often I will do favorite videos. I think I will do them like if I have a lot of new things that I really been loving or old things that I rediscovered. But yeah, these are my current favorites. I hope that you like that I put in the shoes and a bag as well. And it's always so hard to like end a video. I don't know what's up with me. But yeah. I really hope you liked this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do so you don't miss any of my videos, and I hope I'll see you in the next one. Bye!